friend. It's only been like a year since I've seen you. If you don't know who I am, hello. My name is Abby. I'm a specialist in the United States Army. I am a musician. And a few months ago, GoArmy reached out to me, and they are on a mission to kind of humanize different MOSs in the Army. So I think what a lot of people who don't know how various jobs work in the Army is that it takes a lot of different positions to make a military function, right? Not everyone can just be an infantryman. Some jobs have you sitting behind a desk for your entire military career. There are a lot of different roles that go into making our organization function. If you are a service member, thank you for whatever job that you do, because I know that it is important. And because of all of these jobs together, we get to live in this amazing country and do what we want to do. So with all of that said, thank you so much for being here today. Thank you for supporting me. If you have reached out to me on Instagram, it makes me so happy, because that's what I started documenting this journey for, was to help people, you know, in their Army journeys and fitness journeys. So I'll leave my Instagram handle here. My Ab Gets Fab account is kind of dormant, so reach out to me on AbWeave. And I try to check my comments about once a week, so you can leave questions down there also. I want to do a, you know, my first year in the Army, first year on station type of video, because I've gone through a lot, especially in COVID times. So if you have any questions about, you know, going to your first duty station or things like that, let me know. Again, thank you for your support. I hope you enjoy this video. Let's get into it. Hello, welcome to my car and welcome back to another video. My name is Abby, or Specialist Brunette, and I am a musician in the United States Army. Over the past couple years, I have been documenting my journey to getting fit and joining the Army, and today I am teaming up with GoArmy to show you what it is like to live a day in the life of an Army musician. So I'm gonna bring you along with me today, but right now I'm gonna flip you around. Good morning.
Oh, morning. Good morning.
Excellent. Tillman is practicing already. This is our band hall. Glorious. We got a little gym over there. All right, I'm in our locker room. So there's no one around. So just got to work. It is 10 till 9, so we have formation at 9. Hello, friends. I feel like we're friends. I mean, we drove to work together. So as you saw, we are in admin right now. There's no one in my office, so I'm gonna take my mask off. We do have drill band in a little bit, but I thought I would take a moment and talk to you about having a secondary job within an Army regional band. So the bands function a little bit differently than other companies that might have 200 to 300 people. We have about 40 people here. When it comes to MOSs like admin, supply, etc., other bigger companies may have specific people assigned to work in those offices. Here at the band, us as bands people fulfill all of those roles. I work in admin and my job is to process awards. So someone does something awesome, someone writes an award for them, they send it my way, I do some proofreading, maybe suggest an edit or two, and then it's my responsibility to gather all of the appropriate signatures so that that person can be rewarded for the awesome things they did. They get some promotion points, everyone's happy. So in addition to playing your instrument and performing in your assigned ensemble, staying physically fit, being a soldier, and everything that goes along with that, you may be assigned a small secondary task to do as well. I have a little bit of time right now to check my email and see if there's anything I can do with the awards I'm currently processing, but I'm also going to put some time in on correspondence courses. In order to get promoted, you obviously need promotion points. And one way to earn those is to do some Army education courses. And right now I'm doing a distance learning course on behavioral health. So I'm gonna put some time in on this, check my email, and then we're gonna go outside.
We're trying to avoid market time like this. Here we go, please, on the clicker. Mark time.
Okay, done, shower, change, lunchtime. My friends, we are finally to the music making portion of today. So I didn't mention this earlier, but I am a tuba player. So a little bit about me. I have a bachelor's degree in music education and I have a master's degree in music performance. You don't need a degree to join an Army regional band. You just have to take an audition and win a spot. A lot of my friends and colleagues do have degrees, which I think is pretty cool, but it's not necessary. We have brass quintet rehearsal in a little bit, so I came into the big room we're practicing in to do some fundamentals, get a little warm up in, but I figured I would take this time and tell you a little bit about how the structure of our band works. So here at the 1st Armored Division Band, we have 41 people, and that makes up our large ensemble, like a concert band or a marching band. And then those people get broken down into smaller groups that we call MPTs, or Music Performance Teams. I am a part of the brass quintet, and we support a variety of missions. Some days, we are just rehearsing, and it looks like this. Some days, we are supporting change of command or change of responsibility ceremonies, and we get to play in really cool places like this. All right, hello brass quintet. We're doing a cool mission today. All right, you can stop waving.
No, we're gonna keep waving.
Excellent, okay. We play for a variety of missions. Most recently, we are preparing for an Easter Sunday service. So that's what we're rehearsing today. And I'm gonna give it to future Abby to show you what that looks like. Good morning, friends. All right, it is Easter Sunday. Have a giant coffee. Brass quintet is playing for a sunrise service, so it's 5:15. Gonna head to work, change, and I'll see you when I get there. All right. right, so that is a good overview of what the brass quintet does. We also just finished recording for Music in Our Schools Month so that we could send some stuff out to students in the El Paso community. We did a very large recording project for the entire unit here back in December. But there are many different ensembles here at the 1AD band. We obviously have the brass quintet, a brass band, woodwind quintet, the rock band, and jazz band. So whether you play a traditional band instrument like the tuba or clarinet, there can be a place for you. Or if you play a more rock-oriented instrument like guitar or keyboard, you can find a place to belong. So I'm gonna get warmed up and we're gonna have rehearsal. All right, friends, it is the end of the duty day. We are back home. I thought I should finish this video in my car, have a little ABA form, you know, musician humor. No? Okay. So thank you very much for coming along with me today. Like I said, every day's a little different, and depending what band you go to, it's gonna be different there too. If you wanna know more about my experience, head on over to my YouTube channel and you can see the videos I have there. And if you want to know more about the US Army bands, you can always go to GoArmy.com. So I think it's time I go hang out with my husband and my cat. This is Specialist Burnett signing off. Bye, guys.